Today I want to talk about making your code easier to read. First, let's talk about what it means to make a human language easier to read. The languages that we speak every day have lots of rules, but they also have lots of flexibility, especially when we write them down. Like, if I'm being really lazy one day, I could write this. Now, you can read that sentence and eventually figure it out, but you have to figure out where the periods go, and it takes time. Now, what would happen if we clean that up a bit? Ta-da! Okay, so you agree that that's a lot easier to understand, right? Now, imagine if everybody wrote like this first sentence, and we constantly had to read everything multiple times just to figure out how it flowed. It'd be really painful, right? It's the same thing with programming languages. They have a lot of rules, and they're more strict than human languages, but they can also be written in confusing ways. For example, this code here is valid code, and it runs, and it's a cool program, but man, it's really hard to read as a human. So what would you do to make it easier to read? A few things. The first thing we'd do is we'd move every statement onto its own line, like this. Now, that makes it a little easier to read, but there's still a lot more we can do. So the next thing we want to do is indent the code properly. Now, in human languages like English, we indent to help us understand the structure of writing, like when we indent the first sentence of a paragraph or indent a quote. It's the same thing with code. We indent in order to show the structure of the code. Let me see. Okay, so let's go through this and see how indentation helps us understand the structure. When we talk about structure, we mean functions and for and ifs. So here inside this function, you can see that we indent the first statement inside this function because we want to show that it's inside this function. It's like a child of this function. It's only going to be called if this function's called. All right? And then we have this for loop. And everything that's inside in for loop is indented twice because we're trying to show that this is all inside the for loop. It's all children of the for loop. It's only going to be executed when we go through the for loop. And then finally, inside the if, we indent things three times because we're trying to show that they're child of the if blocks. And they're only going to be executed if this if condition is true. So by using indentation, we can really understand the structure of the program better. Now, the cool thing is that your editor will help you with indentation, right? So if I go and put this on this line and then I just press enter, you see how it just automatically goes and is indented one thing, just like we wanted. So as long as the editor is working correctly, you should actually have correctly indented code. So that's pretty cool. All right, so our program looks pretty good now, but there's still more we can do to improve readability. And I'll give you a hint by showing this English sentence before and after. See these two sentences? They're really similar. The only thing that's different is that we added some white space in between punctuation and letters. And that little bit of white space actually made it a lot more readable. So, once again, it's the same thing with our code. If we just add white space at good points, our code becomes more readable. So here it is with white space. All right, so we added space in between all our function arguments. We added space on either side of the equal sign when we're assigning variables to things. And we added space around operators like less than and greater than and times. And we also added space before curly brackets. And that's it. So now when you look at our code, I hope you agree it's quite beautiful and it's really much easier to understand and you don't have to read through it quite as many times, right? And hey, what I've learned is that cleaning code is actually a lot more fun and easier than cleaning the room, and it doesn't get dirty again. So it's pretty cool, and you should try it out with your programs.